Hello friends, welcome to the next section of our topic isolator, switch and circuit breaker. Today I am dealing with the type of switch gear to the supplier side and consumer side of an electric connection. What is said with our rules and regulations regarding this? So far I have taken some basic terms about isolator, switch, circuit breaker, point of commencement to supply, fuse, etc. And as I said earlier, switch is having making capacity rating only in ampere, but circuit breaker is having two ratings, making capacity rating in ampere and breaking capacity rating in kilo ampere. I request you to refresh through the first video for these basic terms. After watching this video, if you are finding it useful, kindly share with others and also subscribe to my YouTube channel. Okay, let us move to our topic. Thank you. Okay, let us start. Isolator, switch and circuit breaker. So far we have gone through some basic terms. Please refresh by referring to the first video. There I explained about isolator or disconnector, switch, circuit breaker, difference between switch and circuit breaker and different types of electrical faults. Then about the number of poles, about the poles, TPN, SPN, etc. Then about linked switch and circuit breaker. Then different notations. Kindly go through them. Now let us move to the next video. I am explaining here about the consumer side and supplier side switch gears of an electric connection. Here see 1 meter, then a cutout fuse, it is highlighted here. Then switch VC unit. Here to the consumer side, what should be to the supplier side, what should be exactly provided? What is said with our regulation? To the supplier side of the connection, there must be a protective switch gear. We have our safety regulation CEA, which is relating to safety and electric supply. According to regulation 14, there must be a switch gear provided by the supplier before the commencement of point of commencement of supply, and it should be protective type. It is said with the second clause. So in short, there must be a protective switch gear provided at the consumer premises by the supplier. See here, regulation 15, it is said about identification of earthed or earthed neutral conductors and position of switches and switch gear therein. See, depending upon the type of connection, whether it is TPN or TPNC or TT, there will be either earthed conductor or earthed neutral conductor along with the live conductors supplied by the licensee. So, by the licensee, what is said here in the subclause 1, there must be indication of a permanent nature. Means here this earthed conductor or earthed neutral conductor should be permanently marked or permanently identified by the supplier. And see in the second clause, it is said that there should not be any cutout fuse or link or switch other than a linked switch arranged to operate simultaneously to the earthed or earthed neutral conductor and live conductors. Means with the earthed conductor or the earthed neutral conductor, there should not be any cutout fuse or link or switch, but it can be linked with the live conductor so that to work simultaneously. Means the live conductors and the earthed or earthed neutral should be simultaneously opened. Such an arrangement can be done. There should not be any cutout fuse or link or switch with the earthed part of the neutral or earthed conductor. That is said with the regulation 15. Now, to the consumer side, what should be the switch gear? What should be the switch gear provided by the consumer? It should see here, there is a switch VC unit is provided, whether it is correct or no. Let us see. As per regulation 35, there must be a switch gear or as explained in the following table, as far as near after the point of commencement of supply, see the highlighted portion, after the point of commencement of supply means the consumer should provide a switchgear as explained below as near as possible to the point of commencement of supply. See, we are depending upon the consumer's voltage. It is divided into different categories. If the consumer voltage is less than or equal to 650 volt, means LT connection. For such connections, the consumer should provide a linked switch fuse or circuit breaker just after the point of commencement of supply and near as possible to the point of commencement of supply. Means all the LT consumers should provide either a linked switch fuse unit or a circuit breaker. For example, circuit breaker, it can be MCB, a molded case circuit breaker, or miniature circuit breaker. It can be MCB or MCCB. If it is MCB, we can club it with an RCCB, so it is called as RCBO. Means if you are providing, as per this table, if you are providing an MCB, just after the MCB, an RCCB can be added, or the whole unit can be replaced with an RCBO, because many licensees are insisting the consumers to provide RCCB as visible near to the point of commencement of supply. It may be for regular inspection by the licensee. If it is so, it is good. Otherwise, it cannot be insisted, because it is not set with the regulation. As per regulation 42, all the consumers should provide RCCB. But if there is many DBs there, many distribution boards there, it is not necessary to keep the RCCB near this main switch. Okay, next category is the consumer voltage is in between 650 and 11 kV, means ST consumer. If such a consumer is there, and if their consumer, if the consumer's transformer rating is up to 1000 kVA, there must be linked switch fuse unit or a circuit breaker. Linked switch fuse unit or a circuit breaker means we can provide either an STSFU or even a circuit breaker, means VCB can be provided. And above 1000 kVA, the circuit breaker is compulsory. Okay, and the next category is if the voltage is in between 11 and 33 kV and the transformer rating is 2500 kVA, there can be a linked switch fuse unit or a circuit breaker. Means, see, in the first case up to 1000 kVA, it was required a linked switch fuse unit with a circuit breaker. But in the second case, it is extended up to 2500 kVA, because voltage is high voltage, 11 kV to 33 kV. High voltage means current is lower. So this category is enough. Linked switch fuse unit with a circuit breaker is enough. And if the voltage is above 2500 kVA, circuit breaker is must, means VCB is must. And if the voltage is above 33 kVA, VCB is also must. See, there is a condition below that. I already told you it must be provided near as possible to the point of commencement of supply. But there can be a consumer apparatus, means there can be a consumer switch, as explained in this table, near to the point of commencement of supply. Suppose there can be a main switchboard, or there can be a distribution board near to the point of commencement of supply. So in such cases, there is no need of providing an additional switchgear or circuit breaker. It is not required. See, another thing explained here is, see, refer to the red color. For the regulation, safety regulation, there was a draft released in 2021. As per this regulation, actually it is not released, we are expecting it. As per this regulation, instead of 1000 kVA in the first category, it must be 500 kVA, and in the second category, instead of 2500 kVA, it is 1250 kVA. Okay, so, I am closing this section with this portion because as you know, it is a lengthy portion. Just explained about the consumer part and supplier part switch gears. What is said with our regulation, we shall explain other portions later. So to the supplier side, there must be a protective switchgear, and to the consumer side, if it is an LT consumer, there must be a switch, linked switch fuse unit or a circuit breaker. Circuit breaker means it can be an MCB, and if it is necessary, you can club it with an RCCB, and thereby it is called a RCBO. And to the ST side, or if the voltage is between 650 and 11 kV, there can be either linked switch fuse unit or a circuit breaker. If the transformer rating is up to 1000 kVA and above 1000 kVA, there must be a VCB. And if the voltage is in between 11 kVA and 33 kVA, a linked switch fuse unit or circuit breaker is enough. Up to 2500 kVA and above 2500 kVA, there must be a circuit breaker. Actually, it is explained with our regulation, but in many cases, the licensees are taking different measures in different states. Okay, anyway, I am closing here. If you are finding the information useful, kindly share with others, and kindly subscribe to the YouTube channel and support me. And let us see later. Thank you for your patient listening. Thank you.